I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll discuss the search scheduler and how to prioritize scheduled reports that run concurrently in Splunk Enterprise. Reports in Splunk are save searches we want to run again. When we save a search as a report, we have the ability to manage its permissions, have it run on a schedule, or accelerate it. If we start accelerating or scheduling many reports to run at or near the same time, how can we determine which search or report will take precedence? The search scheduler determines the run priority of scheduled reports and alerts. This is important when resources are limited and only a few reports can run concurrently. Historical searches that you run manually always run first. If you start several ad hoc searches at the same time that a number of reports are scheduled to run, some of those reports might get bumped off their schedules to make room for the ad hoc search jobs. The second priority goes to manually scheduled reports and alerts with real-time scheduling, which is the default scheduling type. The third priority goes to manually scheduled reports and alerts using continuous scheduling. The continuous scheduling mode is used by scheduled reports that populate summary indexes, as well as other scheduled reports that cannot have a gap in the collection of report data. And last priority goes to automatically scheduled reports that generate and update acceleration summaries for report and data model acceleration. The Splunk Report Scheduler limits the number of scheduled reports that can run concurrently. Without these limits, your report performance suffers. Splunk determines its system-wide concurrent historical search limit by number of CPUs and attributes defined in the limits.conf on the search head. It does this through a calculation where the primary variable is the number of CPUs in the deployment multiplied by the max search per CPU attribute value, which defaults to 1. Then, it adds the base max searches attribute value that serves as a baseline constant to add to the maximum number of searches, which by default is 6. So if we had 8 CPUs and used the default value specified in limits.conf, we could run 14 searches simultaneously. The report scheduler feeds the system-wide limit for historical searches into another limits.conf parameter, max searches perk. This parameter sets the top number of scheduled reports that can run concurrently by the report scheduler to 50% of the system-wide limit for concurrent historical searches. Looking at the same example as before, the report scheduler can run 7 scheduled reports at a time. A similar parameter, auto-summary perk, exists for scheduled searches to populate summaries for report and data model acceleration, which is relative to the max searches perk value. We can alter both parameters in Splunk Web by navigating to Settings, Server Settings, and selecting Search Preferences. Right below the option to change the default time range for searches is an option to adjust the max searches perk parameter, here labeled relative concurrency limit for scheduled searches. Currently set at 50%, we can use the arrows to increase or lessen the percentage. The next option is to adjust the auto summary perk value in the UI labeled relative concurrency limit for summarization searches. The value shown is 50% of the concurrency limit for scheduled searches, which overall is just 25% of the system limit. The UI will dynamically update the limit of searches that will be allowed to run. In a search head cluster, any limits you set in the UI will automatically replicate to all cluster members. Via the CLI, we can also configure periods when more or fewer concurrent scheduled reports are allowed, using the following attributes to set up alternative percentages for specific cron periods. The N notation can be any non-negative number up to 255. In the following example, we will increase the allowed scheduled searches to 75% between midnight and 5 a.m. on weekdays. Then further increase it to 90% on the weekends, both times when most of our daily users will be inactive. Let's take a look at what would happen if we ran into our concurrent search limit. Report A runs every minute and takes 30 seconds to complete. We see here the scheduler runs report A for the 104 to 105 period and schedules it to run again at 106. Report B runs every 5 minutes and takes 2 minutes to complete. If the scheduler runs report B at 105 and 30 seconds and it takes 2 minutes to run, report B will not finish until 107 and 30 seconds. The scheduler would attempt to run report A, but it cannot because report B is still in progress. It continues to attempt to run report A until 106 and 59 seconds. At this point, what happens next depends on whether report A is using real-time or continuous scheduling. For a report with real-time scheduling, which is the default option, the scheduler skips the 105 to 106 run of the report and schedules the next run of report A at 107 for the 106 to 107 period. While we would have the most up-to-date information, we would have missed the data from the 105 to 106 period. As an alternative, there is continuous scheduling. The scheduler does not advance the schedule and attempts to run the report for the 105 to 106 minute period indefinitely. To configure the report scheduling mode, we will click on Settings, then select Searches, Reports, and Alerts. For the report that needs a scheduling mode change, select Edit, then Advanced Edit. On the Advanced Edit page, we will search for Real-Time Schedule. It's currently set to the default True for real-time scheduling mode. We'd set the value to False for continuous scheduling mode. Then we'll click Save to save our changes to the report. Continuous scheduling is one of two ways to prevent missing results from your scheduled reports. The continuous scheduling mode tries to ensure that every scheduled run of a report is eventually performed. However, the continuous scheduling mode cannot help with data outages that occur when search heads and search peers go offline for periods of time. It also cannot help you with scheduled search runs that return incomplete result sets. To guard scheduled reports against such situations, we can set them up with durable search processing, which uses backfill searches to replace data lost. The report scheduler also applies three rules over the scheduling modes to help reduce the number of skipped report runs. First, scheduled reports are assigned a priority score. Lower average runtimes are given a higher priority to run, while slow completing reports are skipped more often. The next rule is the scheduler will prioritize real-time scheduled reports, allowing them to run first and compete against other real-time scheduled reports. Then, continuous scheduled reports will run next. The third rule is scores will be adjusted to give higher priority to reports that are skipped or infrequently run. After a report is skipped several times, its priority score lets it run ahead of the reports that were forcing it to skip previously. The fourth rule is an optional scheduling window, which we can manually apply for reports that do not need to run at their scheduled start times. To configure a scheduling window, let's navigate back to Searches, Reports, and Alerts. Next to the report we'd like to manage, we'll select Edit, then click Edit Schedule. At the top of the window, we'll ensure the Scheduled Report box is checked before navigating to the Priority and Window Values. We can either leave the priority as default or select a different value from the drop-down menu. As time passes and the schedule window narrows, the report's priority score will improve until the report is allowed to run. This report can run anytime between midnight and 2 a.m. Under the schedule window, we'll select 2 hours and click Save. You do have the ability to disable the search scheduler altogether. However, it's not recommended. When the report scheduler is disabled, scheduled reports, alerts, and summary indexing populating searches will not run. In addition, any actions related to triggered alerts and scheduled reports will not be performed. If you disable the search scheduler in a search head cluster, all members will be affected. If you are looking to resolve a heavy processing load or problems related to the network or hardware, you can try disabling the search scheduler by running Splunk Disable Scheduler. Enable to enable the scheduler, and lastly, Show to check the status. Thanks for joining us to learn more about how scheduled reports are prioritized in Splunk. To continue your journey learning about Splunk, we suggest you check out the documentation. Watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel and register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.